Move your tests into the cloud and test fully automated in a state-of-the-art DevOps workflow. Let's get started with the CANoe Server Editions. In this video, we'll get started with the CANoe Server Editions. Whether you are new to CANoe or you are already using CANoe Desktop Edition, we will get your system testing up to speed, fully automated in a DevOps workflow to enable fast and frequent testing. The CANoe Server Editions are optimized for automated system testing in software-in-the-loop and hardware-in-the-loop environments. It is built for CI/CD workflows, supports everything as code, and allows you to reuse environments and test cases across different stages of your development. Whether you run tests locally, on a server, or in the cloud, CANoe Server Edition scales with your needs. We'll start with the setup. First, we'll install CANoe Server Editions on a Windows or Linux development computers. Because CANoe Server Edition is meant to run on servers, we provide network licenses for it. These licenses normally accessed from a remote license server. There are two ways to configure which license server should be used. The first way is through Vector License Client. The second way is by specifying it in a JSON file that can be placed in the tool's install directory, which does not require installing Vector License Client. I will show you the first option. Make sure Vector License Client is installed and your license server is added to the server search list. Optionally, you might need the Vector driver setup if you plan to work with hardware-in-the-loop setups. We recommend installing Visual Studio Code and our free available VS Code extensions. You'll find them in Visual Studio Code Marketplace. To find the extensions inside VS Code, go to the extension page and search Vector Group. Extensions developed by us will show up. The extensions relevant to CANoe Server Editions help defining, building and executing simulations, developing tests, and other simulation components. These extensions can be combined with other extensions. For example, extensions for Python and C# if your environment includes such components. If you're working already with CANoe Desktop Edition and want to switch to the YAML-based approach, use the Server Edition export functionality within CANoe Desktop Edition. In this example, we have already developed a CANoe configuration. Moving to CANoe, the simulation includes a simulated network and a virtual ECU. I could write a YAML description of this environment, but we are going to use the export feature inside CANoe. The YAML export is created in the same directory where the CANoe configuration is located. Preparation of the VS Code environment involves selecting the right Vector toolset. We are going to select the version and variant of CANoe Server Edition we want to use. Since a project may include multiple environment descriptions, we can use a VS Code command to specify the one we are going to work with. In this case, the exported vEnvironment YAML file. Our VS Code extensions will automatically build the environment. This project also contains a YAML test unit. You can see that the extensions automatically detected the test unit. Also, in this case, there could be more test units available. In the terminal, you will observe the build tasks. Once the environment and the tests are built, you can run the test from the testing page. The test can be executed in debug mode, meaning that you can set breakpoints in the test code and step through the test logic. In this example, we navigate through the test tree to a test case and set a breakpoint to observe the result of a wait condition. The result value has a meaning which is described in the online help. Once we are done debugging, we can continue the execution. The CANoe VS Code extension makes your workflow smoother with auto-completion, syntax highlighting, and validation. Need more? Explore features like traceability, support for multiple test languages, and detailed documentation, all available in the CANoe help system. There are three stages in the DevOps workflow: compiling test environments, compiling test units, and executing tests. This enables scalable CI/CD integration. CANoe Server Edition runs fully headless via the command line, making it perfect for CI/CD integration. Let's walk through a PowerShell script that uses three command line utilities. First, the simulation environments need to be compiled. You can provide multiple parameters, such as the shown output directory. Next, the tests are compiled against the previously compiled environment. Finally, we run the compiled environment in CANoe Server Edition and execute the compiled tests. Again, there are multiple optional parameters that can be provided to CANoe Server Edition prior execution, such as path to a test execution plan. Of course, your environment might need some additional steps, especially if more tools are needed in the test environment. Need help? Don't worry. Explore the CANoe help, the Vector knowledge base, or our online tutorials. If you're new to CANoe Server Editions and want a deeper dive, request a free trial license or book a session with one of our experts. You find all the links in the video description. Thank you for watching. Did you enjoy this video? We have more coming. Subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel and hit the hell out of that bell. But what I like to do most is to have a meeting with you and talk about your use case personally. See you next time. Bye-bye.